Adonai. A panegyric on the Ancient of Days. Olubusayo Aina. Dedication. And every creature which is in heaven and on earth and under the earth, such as are in the sea and all that are in them, I heard saying, blessing and honor, and glory and power be unto him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Amen. Revelation chapter 5 verse 13. Contents. Dedication. Introduction. The source of all. All in all. To him WHO answers prayers. The final authority. Doxology. Epilogue. About the author. Introduction. For the Lord is the great God, and the great King above all gods. Psalm chapter 95 verse 3. The source of all. Yet for us there is one God, the Father, of whom are all things. 1 Corinthians chapter 8 verse 6. Ever imagined what would have been if there was no God? Exactly. Nothing. Trying to even imagine it blanks my mind off. For if the Almighty didn't exist, nothing would have. No skies, no earth, no galaxies, no constellations, no creature, not even a heaven to look forward to. It would have just been a huge and massive emptiness. And we wouldn't even know it, because there wouldn't be any humans with brains existing to conceive the desolation. This is a startling realization, and should keep us humble in the presence of this being to whom we owe our existence and sustenance. Given the fact that this supreme being is in a class of his own, how could our bleak minds possibly comprehend the awesomeness of his majesty? Apostle Paul, in his letter to his protege Timothy, tried to qualify the Lord who alone is God. As it is written, now to the King eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. 1 Timothy 1:17. The Lord is eternal. Simply put, he is not confined by time as we are. He himself created the times and seasons, and he set boundaries for all that he created. He set the sun, moon and stars to order time for his creation on earth. He who set this order, however, is not bound by them. The Lord Almighty dwells in eternity. As it is written, for thus says the High and Lofty One who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place with him who has a contrite and humble spirit. To revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. Isaiah chapter 57 verse 15. Only someone with access to something can give such a thing as a gift to others. Because the Lord dwells in eternity and owns eternity, he is able to give it as a gift to all those who accept his Son as their Savior. For the Scriptures make it clear. And this is the testimony, God has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. 1 John chapter 5 verse 11. Also in another place, the Scriptures reveal, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. John chapter 3 verse 16. Because of his control on eternity, we boldly declare that the Lord lives forever. And to his reign and dominion there will be no end. For it is written, but the Lord is the true God. He is the living God and eternal King. When he is angry, the earth trembles. The nations cannot endure his wrath. Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 10. Adonai dwells in eternity, and eternity dwells in him. He is he who lives forevermore. He created life. He also created death. And both are subject to him. For he reigns from everlasting to everlasting. He existed before all, and he will outlive all. The Lord is immortal. Because of who he is, he can never die. He is imperishable. He is perdurable. He is constant and unchanging. He is immutable. He is inextinguishable. He is sempiternal. He is enduring. He is abiding. The Almighty reigns from everlasting to everlasting, and his tenure will see.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.